Dr. Anthony Harper here, the Intermountain Christian News at the White House, blessed with the Deputy Press Secretary Ryan Morgenstern. Thank you for joining me.
My pleasure.
And it's a very troubling time, and just want to encourage you that a lot of evangelical Christians are praying for you, Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany, President Trump, and so many others here for complete healing and good health. So what is the latest update for President Trump and the Press Secretary and others here?
So the President's feeling great. Those are his own words. Terrific reports from his doctor that he is feeling fine, and he is symptom free. There are antibodies detected in the latest report from the doctor. That's a very good sign. His body's fighting the disease well.
Uh-huh.
And I know that he can't wait to get out there and talk to voters and participate in the debate and really be fully engaged, though he remains working very hard, talking with members on the Hill, doing his job, representing the American people. He's a fighter, and he's going to continue to fight.
You were aware of the recent events. A lot of evangelical Christians were here in Washington, D.C. on the National Mall for the prayer march and for the return. Do you have any comment about that to evangelical Christians that turned out in large numbers here?
Absolutely. It's great to see. And when there have been so many protests around our country for various reasons, it's really important to focus on faith. And that was a great rally where so many people were able to remind really the world of the deep faith that so many Americans have and how that guides us in really how we live our lives. And it's at the root, really, in many ways, at the founding of our country. So really heartening to see. Of course, the president really appreciates all the well wishes and prayers that have been coming our way. I know Kayleigh and myself and the rest of the staff appreciate that very much as well.
I know there was a key verse for the National Day of Prayer. The National Day of Prayer is honored here every year at the White House. And that 2 Chronicles 7:14 verse that Franklin Graham and Rabbi Jonathan Kahn was referring to, actually many of them, those evangelicals, see the solution to America's problems in that verse. And I know that President Trump and others have been referring to it from time to time. And we're in a very serious stage here. I remember also talking with you about the plight of the Jewish people. There's a Jewish cemetery being desecrated in Lithuania. I don't know if you had an opportunity to, if you have any response on that matter yet.
Well, President Trump has been a champion for the Jewish people and really for religious liberty more broadly. Mm-hmm. And so he's been a very loud voice on that topic. He will continue to stand up for religious freedom really all around the world, especially here in America, but in other places as well. So we want religious freedom to be a light in every country as much as humanly possible, and the president will continue to speak out in that regard.
I know I've come to the White House several times about that issue, about the cemetery, very prominent cemetery, and it's the website is savevilna.org. Just for, you know, you can talk with President Trump and Press Secretary McEnany. I know you're very concerned about anti-Semitism. What I have found so far is that anytime anti-Semitism is allowed to reign, the religious freedom religious freedoms go away for many people.
So. Yeah, and President Trump is definitely opposed in all forms to anti-Semitism, and he really wants, you know, religious freedom. We see here in our country, we definitely, the president stands against anti-Semitism. We see now his Supreme Court nominee going to Capitol Hill. She's a religious person. She's a person of faith. She's a Christian. But we see some parts of our society reacting negatively to that, to her Christian faith. That's something that really can't stand. We have to stand up for the Jewish people. We have to stand up for Christians. We have to stand up for Muslims, people who just want to practice their faith in a peaceful way. That's part of what America is all about. And so we will continue to stand as a symbol for religious liberty.
Well, really, we wanted to make it clear for the Jewish people that, you know, that I know, their concern is about any construction on a Jewish cemetery is not allowed and is considered as desecration. I know that Arlington Cemetery, people that are buried there, it wouldn't go over very too well if people moved the graves of the military soldiers and put an entertainment park right in the middle of the cemetery over their graves. And it's very disturbing there as well.
That's a disturbing hypothetical you offer. I'll look into the issue that you're, I know you've mentioned it before. I'm happy to look into that. Again, you know, anti-Semitism certainly has no place in America, and the president certainly stands against anti-Semitism.
Yeah, I know it's really urgent here. They had a court date in Vilnius, Lithuania. My Jewish friends have said recently the lower court judges ruled against and furthering anti-Semitism. And so it's a really huge issue and historic issue for the Jews there. And we sure appreciate, many evangelicals, Orthodox Jews, appreciate President Trump and all your support for those religious freedoms. And any final words that you would like to share with our evangelical viewers, Orthodox Jews that are so a part of this?
Absolutely. We stand with you in your religious liberty. We appreciate all the well wishes that have been coming our way at this time. We are fighting for you. We are going to continue to fight for religious liberty. The president is going to overcome the disease he's fighting right now very quickly, and he will continue to be a voice for all of you and your religious freedom.
Well, it would be great to meet President Trump in person sometime after he gets better here. And hopefully that can be facilitated very soon. It was well with Press Secretary McEnany. I know that wanted to meet with me again, but then she got the news just recently about coronavirus. So we would encourage everyone to pray for Deputy Press Secretary Brian Morgenstern, Press Secretary McEnany, President Trump, and so many others here that have been affected by COVID-19, not only here, but around the world. And it's a blessed time to be here with Deputy Press Secretary Brian Morgenstern. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.